Today, Rinpoche almost concluded the section on training the mind in the stages of the past shared in common with beings of medium capacity, specifically the explanation of the highest higher training in ethics and the four categories contained within that section. Okay, so when once again we're looking at Lama Tsongkhapa's great treatise on the stage of the path to enlightenment, and specifically we're looking at the section on training the mind in the stage of the path shared in common with beings of medium capacity. When we look at that section, we find four categories of the mental training, the measure of the determination to be free, dispelling misconceptions, ascertaining the nature of the path leading to liberation. So this is the four categories in this medium scope section. And we're currently dealing with the category on ascertaining the nature of the path leading to liberation, number four. And in that section, there are two major headings. First, the kind of basis or life needed in order to halt cyclic existence. And then the second category is the kind of pathway needed in order to halt cyclic existence. So we've completed all of those sections up through the section on the kind of life and basis needed to halt cyclic existence. Now we're currently dealing with the end of the kind of path needed to halt cyclic existence. And specifically, Lama Tsongkhapa states that he is going to give a brief explanation of the highest higher training in ethics, even though he's chosen not to describe the other two higher trainings at this point. But he's going to give a brief explanation of that highest higher training in ethics. So this particular section on that training has eight categories according to Jayan Sheba. And in those eight categories, we're in category number category number eight. And category number eight has four categories. The four categories are understanding the antidote to the afflictions. And then the second category is the individual afflictions, the understanding of the antidote of the individual afflictions. The third category is that abandoning the afflictions is the preliminary root of the Buddhist teachings or the Buddhist doctrine. And number four, those who abandon afflictions are a hero, are heroes, are conquerors. So these are the four categories that Jayan Sheba says are contained within category number eight. Okay.
That's also Sheba, the true, the Lari Sheba, the new Hundua, Puyjena, and Nija Dunju Dunjure, Nija Dunju Dunjungulu Masun, Jengaje, Truba the Chidel, the Chidel, Nemuta da Ponas.
Okay, that's cool. The Kamachiku. Okay, so of the four categories, we've gone through that first category of the kind of general afflictions, the understanding antidote of affliction. And then now we're in the second category which is deals with the individual afflictions. So Rinpoche said, it's probably page 349 in English, but I'll tell you specifically in one moment where we are in the English. Okay, then a the susu sheba, then a susu sheba dru ire, then a the ngapa,
the mu kontro, the sha sunganyebo the sonje, and the jule sonyongdua.
Then a the nipa dru the tambo, dru la tambo,
the tambo, and the tumuginyebo the redua.
Tambo, dru la tambo.
Nyomotada.
Okay, diksa. Okay. So now in category number two, there are six different divisions. So category number two are the individual afflictions, antidotes. So we're going to begin with the first affliction, which is ignorance. We're on page 349. It's about three quarters of the way down. The way to eliminate the afflictions is as follows. Beginning with the six root afflictions, among the great misdeeds, ignorance is the most tenacious and serves as the basis of all other afflictions. Therefore, as a remedy for ignorance, you should meditate a great deal on dependent arising and become knowledgeable about the progression and cessation of cyclic existence. If you have habitually cultivated this, none of the bad views, such as the five afflicted views, will occur. So here it says, among the great misdeeds, ignorance is the most tenacious. So this is the reason that Lama Tsongkhapa deals with ignorance first, because ignorance is the strongest, is the most difficult to get rid of. So this word tenacious is being used to show how difficult ignorance is to get rid of. And it says it serves as the basis of all other afflictions. So the ignorance that we're speaking of right now is the grasping at the I as being inherently existent. It's the reifying view of the perishing aggregates, it's the view of the transitory collection, it's called, is the root of cyclic existence, is the basis of all of the other afflictions. It's in dependence upon this ignorance that we have birth, aging, sickness, and death. All negativities arise in dependence upon this ignorance, which is a view of the transitory collection, grasping at the I as being inherently existent. And we find in Chandrakirti's Madhyamika Avatara, the entrance to the middle way, a quote that says that perceiving that all faults and all afflictions flow from the idea of the transitory composite, and knowing that its focus is the very self, this self is what the yogi will disprove. So it shows here in the Madhyamika Avatara that all of faults and all afflictions come from the view of the transitory collection. And the view of the transitory collection is grasping at the I as being inherently existent, conceives of an inherently existent I. This is what that view is, and that's what this ignorance is referring to, and in dependence upon it, all other afflictions arise. So it's like the foundation for all negativity. Okay. When we look at the 12 links of dependent origination, we'll find that all of the links, all of the types of suffering that are found depend upon this ignorance. So the first link of the 12 links of dependent origination is benighted ignorance. And this ignorance is referring to the reifying view of the perishing aggregates, or the view of, I'm sorry, it's called both things, the view of the transitory collection. So it's in dependence upon this view that then all of the other links arise. So this view causes the other 11 links of dependent origination to come forward. So we say that in dependence upon ignorance, we then have compositional activity, and then we then have consciousness, we then have name and form, we then have the six sources. Rinpoche read them in a more abbreviated fashion, but I'm going to read them all. We have the six sources. We have contact, we have feeling, we have craving, we have grasping, we have potential existence, we have birth, we have aging, and death. And all of these other 11 links of the 12 links of dependent origination arise in dependence upon this first link of ignorance, which is the grasping at the I as being truly established. So it says the first, the eighth, the ninth are afflictions, the second and the tenth are karma, the remaining seven are suffering. These are referring to those 12 factors of dependent origination, which all begin with ignorance. Then the chande dendel lungare gari lapson roje chu dendel yan la juni lung
dendel la juni
chu lung lapson
tambo jeba gonyo ngomo lu mar be
ah de lapson tambo jeba gonyo mo de lapson okay
what the mar be
okay okay data yin
तो वो तो तम तम तो तक आते तुम्हारे मरीब तो कि नहीं वो चुना देवा मरुब तो आप गुंगोरे चुना देवा मरु चुना देवा मरुब शिव ते अने चुना देवा तुम्हारे मरीब ले नियमन जोगरे
अब
जो माये बच्चे लू
अब
जो नहीं लो ले नियमन जोगा ना जरे
वो
दस दस उन अने ते नियमन मातु गुंगलास Tumo mariba tegi niyabu mwadu kunguris, chuna demba mariba kungadiru wadaa.
Lesso.
Mwadu kungulaas.
Lesso.
Koa njudu la keba shatis, koa la njubi jundee ni, dungan demba tukunju demba ni.
Lesso.
Koa la tuyu, ne, ngudan da lantay ni.
Lesso.
Koa tesu njudu la keba jiguris.
Lesso.
Keba shati, tesu la yabu kumba ina, ane tawanga la suba thaji yungma yungma res
basa
tawanga jita thata luta chirin tu chunzi ta chunzi ngat marve
basa
jita lo su tu su basa tesul ne nu gojer
basa then when we read further it says so I'll just read the sentence before it. Among the great misdeeds, ignorance is the most tenacious and serves as the basis of all other afflictions. Therefore, as a remedy for ignorance, you should meditate a great deal on dependent arising and become knowledgeable about the progression and cessation of cyclic existence. So here, the antidote for ignorance, the benighted ignorance, the first link of dependent origination, is the understanding of phenomena as being not truly established. So once one understands that phenomena is not truly established, this serves as an antidote or an opponent to the grasping at the I as being inherently existent, or as grasping at the I as being truly established. Just like when one walks into a dark room and makes a mistake and thinks that a rope is a snake, the understanding that that rope is a rope is the only thing that gets rid of the mistaken view that believes that it's a snake. And once one knows it's a rope, you no longer believe it's a snake. You now know it's a rope. Likewise, when you misapprehend cyclic existence, you misapprehend the I, believing that the I and phenomena are inherently existent, that mistaken view creates all other afflictions and all other faults. But the antidote to that mistaken view, and the only antidote to it, just like the only antidote to mistaking the rope for a snake is knowing that it's a rope, is understanding that phenomena and the I are not truly established. This understanding negates the misapprehension of phenomena, because misapprehension is believing that it is truly established. So this is how one rids oneself of that first link. It says, meditate a great deal on dependent arising. And then it says, and become knowledgeable about the progression and cessation of cyclic existence. This is referring to the two cause and effect relationships that we find in the Four Noble Truths. When we look at the Four Noble Truths, we see the first two Noble Truths are the superior truth of suffering and the superior truth of origin. These two truths show how one is bound to cyclic existence, how one is kept in cyclic existence. The next two Noble Truths, which are the truth of cessation and the truth of path, show how one is freed from cyclic existence. So here it says about the progression and cessation of cyclic existence. The progression of cyclic existence is the truth of suffering and the truth of origin of suffering. So the progression is the truth of suffering. The truth of origin is what creates it. The cessation of cyclic existence is referring to the cessation of suffering, which is the third noble truth, and the cessation of cyclic existence occurs by cultivating a path, which becomes what creates that lack of suffering. So this is what is meant by knowledgeable about the progression and cessation of cyclic existence. And it says, if you have habitually cultivated this, none of the bad views, such as the five afflicted views, will occur. So if you've habitually cultivated the understanding that phenomena is not truly established, then the view of the transitory collection will not arise. The view holding to an extreme will not arise. The conception of a bad view as supreme will not arise. Conception of bad ethics and modes of conduct as supreme will not arise. And perverse view or wrong view will not arise. So these five views are what the five afflicted views are referring to. And those will not arise if that benighted ignorance is gotten rid of. And the antidote to it is understanding that phenomena lacks true establishment, understanding or meditating a great deal on dependent arising. So this is the antidote to the first of the afflictions discussed here in the second section called the individual afflictions of the eighth category.
Tanya Tawa. And then Nanjel is Jipa.
Nyomon Chen Maripa, Nyomon Chen Tetsun. Okay,
they do. Not in the Nga. Nyomuji Tawa de Langa Jan Tawa Res.
Then Nyomo, the Yine, they do. Ducha Kontro Maripa.
Ducha Kontro Nga Jan Nyomuji Maripa, Nyomuji Tetsun. Nga Maripa Nga.
Then a Drupa Gare.
Drupa Nyomuji Tawa de Langa Jan.
Nyomon Chen Tawa. Okay, Gonga Mebuchi. Nyomo. Okay, sorry. So when we look at the six afflictions that are dealt with, there are five of these afflictions are called viewless afflictions, and one of the afflictions is called afflictions that are of view. So the six of afflictions that we're speaking of are attachment, hatred or aversion, pride, afflicted ignorance, afflicted doubt, and afflicted view. So the first five, attachment, the Maripa Kabiore Rimache.
Deja Kundu Naje, Nyomujeji Maripa, Nyomujeji Maripa.
You know, the Laren Chenmo Tambo, the Timu, the Kakare.
Timu, Kunduji. And then the Tambushig will soon show you Murota.
Then the Nyomon Chen Maripa Gula Yerbe.
Nyomuji Maripa, the Woodl Tal Kalit Nyomuji Maripa.
Then they got it, they drew Gare Rimache, Kabiore, the Ducha Control Nanja, Nyomon Chen Maripa.
Sanyun True, sir, Sanyun True.
Sanyun True.
Sanyun Nyomon Batuja Gre. Simitsa Taji True, Zue Netuba, Netuba.
That's so.
Less so.
So I was just trying to clarify, because obviously we begin with ignorance in the Lamrim Chemo, and then we find these six. So these are the six, Rinpoche is saying that this is from the Abhidharma Kosha, what they say, that's the six root afflictions. And the six root afflictions are attachment, hatred or aversion, pride, afflicted ignorance, afflicted doubt, and then afflicted view. So these are the six that are found. And five of those are viewless, and one of them is view. So when we look at the view, we have the view of transitory collection, view holding to an extreme, conception of a bad view is extreme, conception of bad ethics and modes of conduct is extreme, and perverse view. These five fall under that category of afflicted view. And it's from this afflicted view. Afflicted view is called view because it requires some sort of reasoning, analysis, incorrect analysis to arrive at that. So it's considered view, and it's in dependence upon that that other non-view afflictions occur. So that's why the one there are categories like that, view and viewless, because the one that is view requires this thought process, incorrect thought process, where the viewless, just attachment and so forth, isn't a basis for other arisals. It is arises from the basis of a mistaken view. So that's what's meant by that. And just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. Why am I here? Okay, we're done with that. Done with that. Nyetsampa kangala son.
What done this as on tanyiba? Nyetsampa. Kontrugnyebo. Ndishinyiga so kontro tanyiba. Ndishinyiga dunge tishi. Gaza saba na jumbi drane shidan yindes. Kontro la tene tumu shidan la tene. Sindile dunge yungre. Tsashima penjile dunge yungre. Dunge tishi. And so, Sasha, the Gawakangalo member Chazuris, Gaza Tanjin Jumbi Dane, Shedan Yetes, Shedan Yet Shunule, Shedan Tabi Dibame, Shesun Bataros, T. Shedella, Naba Tanjito, Kamewa, Zubalambetos, and Kundalansun over there, Telekomeo, Zubakunguris, the Majuna. Zoba de Magumba in Ano Kondiji de Baina, ne de Temajuna, Sendini Lion Chi Shinto, Kondu de Majunas, Kondu de Majuna, Sendini La Shibibi Ungres, Sendini La Shinto Dede, Chi Shinto Dede, Kaji Din to Tunjuba, then the Tangent of De Shunu Imare. Jinhe do conto do Juba Yina, Senda da Chama Nigal de Bungres, Shunju Lusumba Taros, or Tabadu de Nibadredua.
Lessa. So number two deals with aversion or anger. So it says hostility. Hold on a second. Hostility is the Shunju, the long rasum tearing. Hostility is the enemy who brings suffering both in this and future lives and who destroys the accumulated roots of virtue. As engaging in the Bodhisattva deed says, there is no sin like hatred. Therefore, never give hostility an opportunity and make every effort to be patient. If hostility does not arise, you will be very happy even in this lifetime. Engaging in the Bodhisattva deeds, those who persistently defeat anger will be happy in this and other lives. So that's a quote from the Shantideva's Bodhichara Avatara. Okay? So we should, the way that we combat anger is by meditating upon or familiarizing ourselves with patience. So when we look at the points that are made in different texts about anger and about the need to meditate on patience, we find that there's kind of different points made about when we look at two specific texts. When we look at Chandrakirti's entrance to the middle way, and we look at the Madhyamika Avatara, and we look at Shantideva's guide to the Bodhisattva's way of life, there seems to be a little bit of a different point made about how long, is destroyed by becoming angry at a bodhisattva. And it's clarified in the commentaries, but the difference that's made is that it says that in the Guide to the Bodhisattva's Way of Life, it says, whatever wholesome deeds, such as venerating the Buddhas and generosity that have been amassed over 1,000 eons, will all be destroyed in one moment of anger. So the Guide to the Bodhisattva's Way of Life states that 1,000 eons of virtue and wholesome deeds are destroyed by a moment of anger. And then in the chapter 3 of Chandrakirti's Madhyamika Avatara, we find, it says, indeed, all anger felt toward a bodhisattva destroys within an instant merits that arise through discipline and giving of 100 eons. No other evil is similar to wrath or anger. So here it says 100 eons, and in the Shantideva's it says 1,000. So what's the difference? So when we look at the commentaries, it states that in Shantideva's text, this is referring to one who is not a bodhisattva that gets angry with a bodhisattva. When one who is not a bodhisattva gets angry with a bodhisattva, this destroys 1,000 eons of virtue. But when one is already a bodhisattva, but gets angry at a bodhisattva who is higher on the path, then this destroys 100 eons of virtue that's been amassed. So for instance, if a bodhisattva is on the path of accumulation and gets mad at a bodhisattva who is on the path of preparation, then this anger, because of the power of the basis, would destroy 100 eons of virtue collected. Whereas someone who's not a bodhisattva that gets angry at a bodhisattva at any level destroys 1,000 eons. So that's what the difference is in the points made in Shantideva's Bodhichara Avatara and Chandrakirti's Madhyamika Avatara. Diksum, Nicha Rasam.
Oh, that then what the Kundra Gita then you the Kundra Kamajan was over.
So the anger that destroys those root virtues can be combated with our patience. Meditation upon patience is very beneficial. And by meditating upon patience, it's stated that one in one's future life will have a beauty, and one will be able to quickly gain his or her goals, and then be born, if one has to again, in the higher realms with the gods and demigods and so forth, and humans and God's realms. And then we find in Lama Tsongkhapa's abbreviated stages of the path, the Lamrim Duden, where it states of the excellent qualities and the excellent benefits that we achieve through being patient. And it says, patience is the best adornment to wear for those with power and the perfect aesthetic practice for those tormented by delusions. It is the high-soaring eagle as the enemy of the snake of anger and is the thickest armor against the weapons of abusive language. Knowing this, the wise have accustomed themselves in various ways and forms to the armor of supreme patience. I, the yogi, have practiced just that. If you would also seek liberation, please cultivate yourself in the same way.
What
Again, number two is dealing with the antidote to hostility, or it's translated as anger or aversion. And it says, if anger or hostility does not arise, you will be very happy even in this lifetime. And then there's, again, Shantideva states, those who persistently defeat anger will be happy in this and other lives. Okay. So now we arrive at number three, which is the opponent to attachment.
Mado Gunla Duba Shates Talhubin Iniches Rida Lambu Shemaletanya Drama Ngai Chonjute Chigin Juna Kanda Kanji Nganane Tatu Temba Chishin Juman Jur Shesun Sos Whatabat the Shagin Yabedwa.
So now number three, the opponent or the antidote to attachment. It says attachment, Attachment, that is craving, strengthens all previously accumulated virtues and non-virtues and enhances their power to create cyclic existence. For those in the desire realm, craving arises from the feelings caused by the mental process of contact, which involves sensory objects. Therefore, you should meditate a great deal on what is externally or internally unpleasant and on the faults of being attached to desirable objects and thereby overcome your craving and attachment. The Lopuninye Lung Labgoy. Oh, the Lassen.
Lassen. Drama ngabu ngai chungju de, se drama ngabu ngai chungju de, chikin chung na, kanji ngana ne, tatu tenpa chishin chung minjuro, shesun bataro wad wate, tepat wate, dweshaka nyebuta renduwa, dweshaka nyebutawa, dweshaka nyebu yindu lawa, ta tentesu wate ta, dweshaka dalita sedhukta wata, Gile ta magile, gile la tena koal chigre, magile la tena koal chigre, gile la tena koal chibata, magile la tena koal chibi, lenji shija tud ndochares. Ndocha gile lenji shiba la tena koal chiungure, ndocha chi magile la lenji shijin shiba la tena, and koal rubi juitu, lenji shijin ndochares. Gimagile. Hansaba Tanji, Kuanduba Tujin to Shiji, Nubajis Tumane, Dosaj Siba in Las, Gimigile, Chua Tuma Mabatan Tatiba to Sashabi, Kuandubile to Zo, Nubatujin Tanking Lenji Shiji, Chulu Tabute, Docharis, Tujin to Shiji, Nubajis Tuman, Dosaj Siba in Las, Teon do Companas. Zukan dokan zumekan. Dokan banane yula longe bize bi genji ne yula longe bize bi genji tuwa yungurda tuwa. Ne megzu tuwa latende tuwa dwa chigre dungen chigre na dra tuwa latende tuwa dwa chigre dungen chigre ten naji sheba droge tu latende tuwa dwa tan dungen chigre wata. What the what is on the inside.
Then the Rinpoche, the Nga, the Jawagare, the Nai Yu, Jayu, Jiyu.
That means make Shaba Nai Shaba Nai Shaba, she Shaba Lui Shaba, he Shaba Tru Marbe Tru. Shaba Tru, you don't want to talk about the Tua Dua Chu Marbe. You don't want to attend there and control Jim or control. And then you don't want to attend the Tua Dua Chigre, Tua Dua Latin de Chachim with us. You don't want to attend there and control Jim with us. Tua Dungage, Tua Dungelatin, control Chigres. What the lady is a mother?
Nagare.
Naz make Shaba Nala, Nishaba, Chishaba, Lushaba, Ishaba, True Yungro True.
Yene, the Lopo Nine Long Ninga, the Yichi Sheba Yomare.
So, when you get the Nas at the Rada, the Rada, the Meter, the Rada, don't draw. And in each Rada, and then GJ, Lambuchet and Yiji, Shemali, the Sunji, Nyata, Jiji. And then drama than got him today. Tundunga, Tundunga, what the Tundunga de Tundunga with the Tak on the
Duenga.
Duenga take a Tundunga and June Grace with that. Tundunga de and a Redache, Lambuche, Shemaleje, Nyache, the Dramangaro, Dramanga with the Dramanga with Duenga and June Jungles. Doing at the zoo, da, te, ro, reja.
Okay.
Reja at the marble.
Okay.
Reja at the gate.
Okay, two chain.
Reja at the gate.
Two chain.
And the redan don't join the gray. Trombuchin join the gray.
Okay.
Shemalin join the gray. Nyan join the gray.
So do.
And the draman join the gray.
So do.
What the lady is that?
Okay, two chain. Sorry about that. It says attachment that is craving. Let me just make sure my pen. Attachment that is craving strengthens all previously accumulated virtues and non-virtues and enhances their power to create cyclic existence. So virtue and non-virtuous action both create cyclic existence. So it's not only non-virtue that creates cyclic existence. Because if there is attachment serves as a cooperating condition for cyclic existence to occur. So if this attachment is present with the virtue, attachment is present with the non-virtue, then that gives rise to cyclic existence because the cooperating condition is present for the arisal of cyclic existence. So since beginningless time, we've been born again and again and again. We've had this reoccurring rebirth, and this reoccurrence has happened because of our attachment. So our attachment has always been this underlying cooperating condition that has allowed for the experience of cyclic existence to occur. So it says attachment enhances their power to create cyclic existence. That enhances means is a cooperating condition for their creation. So it says, for those in the desire realm, craving arises from the feelings caused by the mental process of contact. So when we feel something that we like, then we become attached, we become happy. When we feel something we don't like, then we become angry, we have aversion toward it. So in the form, in the desire realm, rather, we have this contact occurs in terms of, in relation to sensory objects, and then how we feel about those determines what our affliction or will be. So that if we feel we find it desirable, then we become attached. We find it undesirable, then we have aversion towards it. All this process of contact involves the sensory objects that we apprehend and then judge, basically, make determinations on, and then react to. Therefore, you should meditate a great deal on what is externally or internally unpleasant and on the faults of being attached to desirable objects and thereby overcome your craving and attachment. Here where it says internally unpleasant, the word that's used is the word for ugliness. When the opponent for attachment, as the translators know, we always say is meditation on ugliness or impurity. They're using internally unpleasant as opposed to impure or ugly, but that's what's meant here. And on the faults of being attached to desirable objects and thereby overcome your craving and attachment, because meditation upon ugliness is the opponent or antidote to attachment. So the great master Basubandhu says, the five beings, deer, elephant, butterflies, fish, and bees, are overcome by the five desirable objects. If a desirable object can overwhelm each of them, why shouldn't all five destroy someone who constantly dwells on them? So we have six types of consciousness. We have eye consciousness, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, tongue consciousness, tactile consciousness, and mental consciousness. So we have all of these different types of consciousness. And then we have five types of things that are apprehended, objects of apprehension of these different consciousnesses. So we have we have things, tastes, we have smells, we have forms, we have tactile sensations, reja, zu, dra, dri, ro, reja, zu, forms, sounds, smells, tastes, and tactile sensations. So those are the five objects that
Basu chuji ja sen ta ngaw ra je ke ndeba no ndu rada limbi da su ji tomba sa rada de limbi da su ji tong res limbi da che bi de rada anju ne na ko telung ko ku ne ku su shwe da ji men do a limbi da su ji rada tong de res
rada gapul do
rada limbi dal gabe ji ro ta ko mle su no
Less so.
Tene
nya
rui chumbas kurul chane nya shinde ruta nya rul chane chal ten ur
okay
rui chumbas ha
then this sa chi shina
bama te chumbas te bomb de wat de trick in chung ur te ini ji gumba
then the
gumba yin no sa
Then the bee, gare, the tama, the ngapa, nya, the
Bama the tre, tre, sama.
Dene, the buyerbe.
Telcha na kuchi, nyanji, yujiru.
Smelling, okay.
Ngaura jik chen ol tendu.
Less so. Ngaura apche dang basu chuji jetsin?
Basu chuji jetsin du, ngaura jien du.
Okay, so so when we look at the four interwoven commentaries, we find in basu chuji jetsin's and Ngawan Rapche's commentary, points made about these five beings. So just as a translator's note, there's four authors in the four interwoven commentaries. So Ngawan Rapche and Basu Chuji Jetsin are two of the four also, and Jayan Sheba is also. So those are the three most prevalent. Then the Rinpoche, the Jipa Surabe, Jayan Sheba, Basu Chuji Jetsang, Ngawan Rapche Dang, Jipa Gare, Su.
Jipa Su.
The Delpa, the Chiken, Je Yere, Jayan Sheba, Basu Chuji Jetsang, Ngawan Rapche Dang, Jipa Surabe.
No, Raji, that's the Chi, you're a Basu Chuji Jetsang. That's the Chi, you're
a Okay, 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 so the five beings. So the commentary says the deer are attached to music. So sometimes hunters would play this flute or a noise that would attract deer. Maybe even like a call, like a flute that would attract a deer. And then the deer would become mesmerized by this, and then they would easily be able to be killed by the hunter. So the deer becomes attached to this sound and then is killed. So elephants are attached to tactile sensation. They become very itchy and itch, and they try to everything they can to itch themselves, and they can harm themselves by trying to itch because of this tactile sensation that they have. Butterflies are attached to light and like butter lamps. So they would fly towards a butter lamp, and they would die because of being attracted to the light and fly into the fire. Fish are attracted to the food and shiny objects, so therefore a fisherman can very easily hook them and take them out of the water. And then bees, it just says they're attracted to smell. It doesn't say anything else, but it says they're very, in the commentary, it says are very attached and attracted to things that smell. And then this becomes problematic. So this is what the commentaries say about these five types of beings and why these examples are used and relate to how we become attached to things, and it creates cyclic existence and so forth. We'll take a short break. We'll be right back. We'll have snacks.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
I just my boss. I know. Rinpoche wants to start. I just. He keeps saying start. I gotta text my boss. Okay. Deeksung, go ahead. I can do both. So now we get to the next number four, which deals with the eight worldly dharmas. So overcoming the eight worldly dharmas. Moreover, the four cravings for gain, fame, praise, and pleasure, and the dislike for their four opposites are quick to occur and difficult to get rid of. Strive to remedy this and stop these eight worldly concerns by meditating on the faults of cyclic existence in general and by cultivating the mindfulness of death in particular. So the eight worldly dharmas are very difficult to get rid of, and it says they're quick to occur. So they arise very, very easily, and even though they're easy to have, they're very difficult to not have, to get rid of. Jayan Sheba states that the eight worldly dharmas or eight worldly concerns are as follows. Getting a gift or not getting a gift, having fame, not having fame, being praised, not being praised, and being happy or not being happy. So these are the eight worldly dharmas. So it's the concern about those things and their opposites. So the concern about getting something or being concerned about not getting something, being concerned about fame or not being famous. All of these things fall, being concerned about being famous or being sad that one's not famous, being concerned, craving praise and being upset about not being praised, craving happiness and being upset about not being happy. So these are what the eight worldly concerns refer to according to Jayan Sheba. Getting something, craving getting something, being upset about not getting something, craving fame, being upset about not being famous, craving praise, being upset about not being praised, craving pleasure, being upset about not having pleasure or happiness. So these are the eight. And, Detsuko, and it says we meditate on the faults of cyclic existence in general and then cultivate mindfulness of death in particular. So the specifics about death and impermanence. Dikson.
And then I Lena Dagger Dagger Shale Mandeshe Tata Yanta Yanto Samba Ne Dene Nyebo Nyebi Gune Jabin Juro Shesum Bataro Shesum Bataros Ne Dembatan Kunjutan Lendela Neba Nyena Nyena Ne Tatunji Taji Manungo Tatunji Taji Manungos What about the Najeg Nyebu Tangan Najedo Lena Dag Shale Mandish, Lena Dag Shale Malish, Tata Yanta Yan to Samba Ne, T. Nebugun Jabanjuro, Yana Yan to Samba, what the Nebu Yana Yan to Samba Yina, Nebugun Jabanjuros, Najak Kimba Jabba Ne, Najak Kimba Jabba Ne, Najet Kimba Jabba, Najet and Kimba Jabba to the Tays Shabbat Wode, Jabba to Yumar Summer, she didn't let. And then I do a chi doing it. The Santa Bayina does not teach you to Lena Dag Shale Mandishi. Tada Yanta, the Sabane,
Okay, so now we move on to pride, number five. Eliminate pride as it is the chief obstacle to the development of the path in this lifetime and causes future rebirth as a servant and so forth. The way to do this is stated in Nagarjuna's friendly letter. If you reflect again and again, just as I have not transcended illness, aging, death, and loss of the pleasant, so my karma and its results are my own doing. You will overcome arrogance because you will be applying its remedy. Once you have achieved certainty about the truths, the three jewels, and karma and its effects, the affliction of doubt will not arise. Here, it's saying that pride causes a huge obstacle and makes it impossible for us to cultivate the paths in this lifetime. So the paths are referring to the path of accumulation, the path of preparation, the path of seeing, the path of meditation, the path of no more learning. So that's what here is being referred to as paths. So in order to achieve any results, it's necessary to engage in the pathways. Pride is the chief obstacle to the development of the path, then it needs to be gotten rid of. And then it says, and causes future rebirth as a servant and so forth. And it says the way to do this is stated in the friendly letter. So this Nagarjuna's letter shows us how to abandon pride, what to think about in order to get rid of it. It says, if you reflect again and again, just as I have not transcended illness, aging, death, and the loss of the pleasant, so my karma and its results are my own doing. You will overcome arrogance because you will be applying its remedy. So arrogance is this idea that my physical and mental parts, like my body is very attractive and my mind is very good, and therefore I know I am attached and to myself in this way because I feel that my body, I'm rich. Rinpoche is saying I'm rich, I have a beautiful body, I have a great mind. This is what arrogance is referring to. And when we reflect again and again on the fact that we haven't transcended, as great as we are, we haven't been able to transcend illness. We haven't been able to transcend aging. We haven't been able to transcend death. We haven't been able to stop losing what we like. We haven't been able to stop losing the pleasant. So therefore, all of the things that happen to us are a result of our doing, because they are because of our actions that we are in the experience that we are. So that fact allows us to get rid of that arrogance that sees ourselves as being having exaggerated qualities It's not saying that we should see ourselves as bad. It's saying that we are exaggerating and being attached to these qualities and feeling superior because of these qualities. And when we realize that these negativities still occur because of our own doing, this lessens that arrogance and lessens then the pride. Rinpoche said that pride is a little bit is different than arrogance. Those are two different words that are being used. And one can be prideful and arrogant. So arrogance, when one starts to remedy this, then one's pride is also lessened. When one, what one is arrogant about is lessened, then one's pride is lessened. Diksum.
Number 6. Chua kwenzin tseba chaba, sana chadu yo jo jaba, ngusa meba, nansi ngusa meba, tri meba, watan chiki nishu yo
ta nishu.
Tendu ma nyanyo ki nishu, nyebi ten yung du usun ta.
Lesa. So, when we, now we arrive at number 6, and this deals with the secondary afflictions. So, when we look at the afflictions and we divide them, we divide them into, oh, I know where this is. We divide them into categories of root afflictions and secondary afflictions. So the 6 root afflictions are attachment, hatred, pride, afflicted ignorance, afflicted doubt, and afflicted view. So those are the 6 root, the 6 root afflictions, and then the 20 secondary afflictions are belligerence, resentment, concealment, spite, jealousy, miserliness, deceit, dissimulation, haughtiness, harmfulness, non-shame, non-embarrassment, lethargy, excitement, non-faith, laziness, non-conscientiousness, forgetfulness, non-introspection, and distraction. So these are, excuse me, the 20 secondary afflictions. So we find this, Rinpoche was saying, in the mind and reasoning section, the Lohrig teachings. We defined all of these different divisions. So the 6 root afflictions and then the 20 secondary afflictions. So here, going back to the Lamrim Chenmo, we're speaking of the secondary afflictions. Okay.
Yin Sen not to do as you wish, legend, send you the Nick Senior is Nick.
Oh man.
Nick and the Saint Dunner, what send not to do as you wish, legend, send you the need is Nick. Nick come to us what the send you not do as you wish, legend, send you the world. Need it. Need the gentry, Nick, go out, you are a Magoa, you are a Lomatin, you are a Sunga, you are a.
Sumyure. Secondary, I saw these. So when we look at sleep, contrition, is this it, please? When we look at these secondary afflictions, the kanga semjong? These are all mental factors. So when we look at sleep, sleep is defined as a powerless withdrawal inside of the engagement by sense consciousness and objects. So it's a powerless withdrawal inside of the engagement by sense consciousness and objects. So that's the definition of sleep. And So when we look at the low-rig teachings, we find that there are definitions of all of these things. There's definitions of the mind, there's definitions of mental factors. So the, just give me 1 minute. So Rinpoche said in the future, we can go over and pull all of these exact definitions out of what, you know, the definition exactly of a mind, the definition of a mental factor. I can find it in 2 seconds, but he said, let's just, we'll find it in the future. Okay, Deekson. Thinking of other. Gopi seni kabi ore. They kanga.
Lori to batena yojere. Lori.
Lori yirebe.
Lori ala kadul den jema ta ko jema.
Okay. Rinpoche is saying that in the future we'll get all the exact definitions. He's saying them real, very fast. And I asked him where they're from, and he said that we'll find them. So the he's giving the definitions of all of these different sleep, lethargy, excitement, laziness, and so forth. So I just don't want to miss any commentary looking for some of these things. So we'll just table anything that I can't just translate quickly till I can just get the exact definitions. So mupa yanjur surlang, that's
mupa surlang tunyil mi na tunyil mi shi mo dia jumo di chawang haji kanda yina nyabe mo dia jige ane shi shi tu chawat na san tan shi mo do mi shi ba jin do wa mo ba la ma ba.
Okay, so the next, which is lethargy, is referring to when there is a darkness of mind, a heaviness and unserviceability of the mind in terms of, you know, trying to think about, for instance, emptiness and not being able to really clearly do so. There's an inserviceability that's there in terms of what we're trying to use as our object of observation. And then excitement is the scattering of the mind, meaning that if one is thinking about something other than what one is trying to think about. So that's excitement. When you're trying to focus on something and you're thinking about something other than what you're trying to focus on, then this is excitement. So it's a scattering of the mind. Is what excitement is. These might actually be the exact definitions, but I don't want to say for sure that they are. So it's a scattering of the mind. Then a lelo.
Da lelo sene tuwa te kasukure ane shishui jimi lelo marbe lele ta tandanga chikun tandanga yungu mar jema che chukure samba shishui jimi lelo.
Te tseni gare?
Tseni lelo.
The Gewa Magawa. So the next is laziness. And laziness is saying that I'll do this later. I'll do the meditation later. I'll engage in virtue later. They found this a non-delight in virtue due to attachment to lying down and so forth. That's what it says in the text here. Rinpoche is saying that one's attached to just putting things off and saying, I'll do that later. It almost sounds similar to what we put procrastination, the way Rinpoche is explaining it. Okay.
Okay,
so the next is carelessness. And carelessness is the opposite of mindfulness. So if one is being mindful, one is saying, what am I doing? How is my behavior? Am I engaging in the 10 virtues? Am I abandoning the 10 non-virtues? If one is not paying attention to that, then this becomes carelessness. So it's like a loosening. It says here, I'm just going to read these because they're usually the same ones. He uses the same root text as Drepung for all this stuff. It says, a loosening of the mind, not keeping it from afflictions and faults, resulting in non-cultivation of virtuous phenomena. So it's not being conscientious. It's not being mindful. It's the opposite of that. Okay, Dig Sung Rinpoche. So then we get shamelessness and lack of embarrassment. Shamelessness is referring to ourselves. So if we have shame, if we are have been acting in a way that's contradictory to the Dharma, and we feel bad about that because we know we aren't doing what we're supposed to be doing, then this is a sense of shame. But if we don't have that in regards to what we should be doing and don't care, then this is shameless. And the difference between shamelessness and lack of embarrassment is embarrassment is referring to what you think others will think of you. So if you think others will think badly of you because you're engaging in non-virtue or society won't agree with the things that you're doing, then this is embarrassment. But if you don't care what others think, then this is lack of embarrassment. So the difference between shame and embarrassment, shame is referring to how one feels about oneself and what one's doing, and the embarrassment is how one feels about what others thinks about what one is doing.
Okay.
Less so. So then we have forgetfulness and the lack of vigilance. Forgetfulness is literally what it says. We could forget our keys. We could forget where we put something. We forget our book. Forget to look at our book. So these all fall under the category of forgetfulness. And lack of vigilance. If one has vigilance, then they study very hard. They go for their studies and looking at the text in a very strong way. But when one isn't doing that, when one isn't really, it sounds like it's almost inspired in a little in the word that we're looking at here inside the vigilance. It's going forth and working hard because of this inspiration. When that isn't there, that's the lack of vigilance. So Rinpoche said in the low rig, we can find all of these different, yeah, they're right here, all of these different afflictions. In the future, we'll look right at the text that it's in. Yeah, they're all right here. Less so. So then it says, are quick to occur, so we're talking about sleep, lethargy, excitement, laziness, carelessness, shamelessness, lack of embarrassment, forgetfulness, and lack of vigilance, are quick to occur and hinder your cultivation of the virtuous group of phenomena. You should understand their faults and get used to reducing their strength through an immediate application of their remedies. With respect to their faults, the friendly letter says. So here again, Lama Tsongkhapa is choosing to quote Nagarjuna's friendly letter, or letter to a friend, to show where this information came from. It says, excitement and regret, malice, lethargy, and sleep, longing for the desirable, and doubt. Understand that these five obscurations are robbers who steal the riches of virtue. So here we see these secondary afflictions that Lama Tsongkhapa states will it says, are quick to occur and hinder your cultivation of virtues, of the virtuous group of phenomena. And here it says, are robbers who steal the riches of virtue. So Lama Tsongkhapa shows how this quote supports the points that he has made, even though there's very little information in Nagarjuna's text. It's implicitly meant. Diksun.
The
Do.
Kanji ni da, kanji makanji, chu kanji, ni da, moba da, ganjo, nil gabuji, moba gabu yoba yina, and a tele, nasa de yungres, ne banking nasa yungre, long nasa yungre, chibi nasa yungres, long chip bankings was members of chi that were the nasa ju to the what the two is a marvel to Susan there. Then what the Pengenji, Lunji, Pengenganasa, Lunganasa, Chibi Nasa, Lunji, Pengansun Latene, and Nasa Kunga Yungus, Pemba Zuki Shed, or things are. Kuzu Logue, Kuzu, Pojin Kuzu Haku, Lunda Pengenda, Chiba to the Karasagres.
So we have also the exhortation to wholehearted resolve discusses the faults at length. Rinpoche said that a lot of the points that are made here would require a doctor who would understand some of these words. So maybe you, doctor, would understand this. It says phlegm, wind, and bile. So these are all the three types of illnesses that are found. So occur to a great extent in the bodies of those who take pleasure in sleep and lethargy. Their constituents are in disorder. For those who take pleasure in lethargy and sleep, their stomachs are unclean because of poor food. Their bodies are heavy and their complexions unhealthy. Even their words are unclear. So anybody in here who's a doctor would know or knows of this phlegm, wind and bile? You know? I was saying that this is very exclusive to the Tibetan medical system. He said, but they have that in Western medicine. I said, we don't really say in Western medicine that every disease comes from these three. We don't have that same point. So the kanga, the data yin, the tsenripa, the kelengumare, the pume. Tibetan medicine. The yure, yene, the dets kakare. He's saying, yes, they do. Ted? Ted, you went to medical school. Do we in the Western medicine say phlegm, wind, and bile? Do we speak like that and say that those are the basis of all diseases in Western medicine?
Not really.
No.
That's a medieval way of thinking.
The
member, that's a little bit of a little bit of a little bit of a
little
bit of a
little bit of a little bit of a little
bit
So according to Tibetan medicine, these three are the basis of all other illnesses. So they check the urine and they, you know, diagnose based on what they feel you have too much of, too much phlegm, too much wind, too much bile, and then they give you a prescription based on your levels of those three. So that's how a Tibetan medicine, how they prescribe, and it's the whole basis of their medicine. So in the future, we'll look into this.
Tadaki, Tadaki Lula, teda ti lula shechirin jong no chi benga somba zubule shechibu yungures ti kana rodu chuban jorus an zubu madeba cha yungures
lasa
tene kangaji mo ta ni la gajo wa kangaji mo ta mo ba ta ni la gabu yoba yina ne kaji ne bi tu ne mada jins ne ni da mobile gabu de te ne kaji sa to a idput
lasa
tu ne mada jin dabu me ba ji lue ji lue jo ji la zubu ji gu sa bu yo
lasa
ji la sundu de mai zubu ma zeba cha yu res
lasa
sundu de mai ti ci jang se wa ma ju ros ke ja xie ci du ma seba cha yu res
lasa
xie dang sa kang ji mo da ni la ga jo wa tene mo xin chu la de ba nya s kang ji ni da kang ji mo ba de ni le ga bu yo ba yin na ane tene mo xin chu la de ba nya s ne mo ba je ne chu le de ne je ne ba nya de re s xie bi yue de gun le yong su nya s xie bi yue de gun le yue de ga nya de re s Susu ju la sheba sa sheba susu ju sa da ai. Kun le yong su nya. Kab nya shi mumba dro ju ro. Kab gwa de nya ne. An mumba ma gwa ju le jong ro res. Dro an ju ro. She nye mi ma do sun ba da. Nye mi mu sun ba da sa. Tan de mu kum mu da do. Tan ba nye ja le do ro do. Tan ba nye ja le. Nyomona ji jine lelo yinte nyomona ji jine wad lelo tsuris lelo yinte lelo de kan la yoba yina su ju la yoba yina ya kan la lelo ji yoba tela chugu me ba yis lelo yokin de ju le ne gi chugu yo me ba chan gres chugu me ba yin she dans yāng chōng lōng jī rāng mabu dāng gāng duwa chōng lē bā mē bā lā yu xie bā jū yu xie bā sāng lā yīn sī bā mē bā lā yu xie bā bā mē jū lī jī bā yī nā xie bī jū yu sāng bā sāng lā yī gī yu sāng bā tī lā nī rī sī mē rō chōng bē nō nāng sōng wā tā rā yī kī dzēn bō chōng bē nō nāng sōng bā tā rā KB Padna Debasha, Pamechi Yumar, Pavichi Wurres, Sazoji Wurres, KB Padna Debasha, She Dansa. Chiro Lejans, Chiro Sujiba Injil, Chiro Lejan, Chiro Le, Lama Sheyan, Musa Benen, Lama Sheyan, Musa Benen, Yila Chudan Gewa. Sheba yus, lawan sheyang, ngotsa pwane ne, yila chudan gewa, sheba yu, jumi nantu, kwe nge chwene ne, jayu chintu, njuwa, zoba la, shetan, Tantan loju shigato, chiro sujiwa
tante,
sanji chonde ne shacha toba, chanzi ki resu chomba resu. Chanzi ki resu chonde, ane kono loma mambal tene, kono gigen kata chanzi ki chui lagan togo shirwa. Chui lagan togo tene, chanzi gigen teke ne loma sul tek lava resu ta. Ane nga chubo resu, ta chusu kuma kogan togo tene, chala su ngal trej was. Lavaris da, gudrutsul. Gudrutsul kuma ngaku gagan chubi yin, ne gudrutsul kuma kukadu na ngala chala teshuwas lavaris.
The gagan getu lapsang?
Gagan getu ladu.
Okay.
Gudrut mancha waka takar ndigiris lavaris.
Okay.
Swanji guju ki tansi tige, wate ngay kuma kukadu kumaris. Ane chunu nung jipi guya tenu yaba yina, ngay tulu chubi jindu tanka nuk yinsi.
Hangar
nun chul
We go back up here. Rinpoche reread this. Phlegm, wind, and bile occur to a great extent in the bodies of those who take pleasure in sleep and lethargy. Their constituents are in disorder. For those who take pleasure in lethargy and sleep, their stomachs are unclean because of poor food. Their bodies are heavy and their complexions unhealthy. Even their words are unclear. So Rinpoche just quickly went through this, that their stomachs are very dirty and bloated, and that their bodies are, feel very heavy, and they lack a beautiful appearance. They don't have a beautiful appearance. Those who take pleasure in lethargy and sleep are confused, and their aspirations toward religion fade. Those children lose all their good qualities, their virtues degenerate, and they fall into darkness. So here it says children are referring to ordinary beings, those who are not superiors. So children refer to those non-superiors. And in the Tibetan, when we look at it, it says, means the same thing, but it says their virtues degenerate, they fall into darkness. The words in the Tibetan are more poetic. It says they fall from their white and move to darkness. So falling from their white means the white virtues have degenerated. It doesn't say their virtues degenerate in the Tibetan. It says they've fallen from their white and they fall into darkness. So just as an aside, it means the same thing as we've learned before, but the translator has chosen to translate the meaning instead of the words. The mindfulness of the excellent teaching says, the one foundation of all the afflictions is laziness. Those who have it, those who have a single moment of laziness, will have no practice at all. So all of the afflictions come about from being lazy. The collection of indicative verses says, those involved in carelessness are childish people who ruin their minds. As master traders guard their wealth, so should you, the wise, take care. And then we have from the Jatakamala, the garland of birth stories, O prince of the deities, rather than cast aside your shame and act at odds with the teaching in your mind, you would do better to take up an earthen vessel, put on poor clothing, and be seen arriving at the home of an enemy. And Rinpoche was saying there's a story in history that's told where there was a teacher who would tell his students that he didn't want to have to go out and beg, and that they could go steal for him and then bring back nicer things, because he didn't want to beg for used things and things that were old and have to go out and humiliate himself. So he asked them to steal nicer things for him. And that story is told by the Buddha, and it relates to this. O Prince of Deities, rather than cast aside your shame and act at odds with the teaching in your mind, you would do better to take up an earthen vessel, put on poor clothing, and be seen arriving at the home of an enemy. So it's saying, rather than doing what you're doing by having them go steal nice things for you, you'd be better off wearing dirty things and show up at your enemy's house because of what is being created by this action. If I left anything out of that story, I apologize. Rinpoche, ngatsu karma sumire. Okay, so we're going to end there. And Rinpoche didn't read the friendly letter, so we'll end there. And we'll do the concluding mandala offering and dedication prayer. So I guess we couldn't finish today again, so we'll finish in the future. But next class, we will finish. This section. The fundamental ground is scented with incense and strewn with flowers, adorned with Mount Meru, the four continents, the sun and the moon. I imagine this as a Buddha land and offer it. May all sentient beings enjoy this pure realm. I dedicate whatever virtues I have collected for the benefit of the teachings and of all sentient beings, and in particular for the essential teachings of Venerable Lozandrapa to shine forever. Send forth this jeweled mandala to you, precious Guru.
I dedicate all this virtue to emulate the knowledge of the hero Manjushri and likewise Samantabhadra as well. Whatever dedication is praised as supreme by all the conquerors who traverse the three times, I also dedicate all my roots of virtue for the sake of auspicious deeds. In that pure land surrounded by snowy mountains, you are the source of all benefit and happiness. All-powerful Avalokiteshvara Tenzin Gyatso, may you stay until samsara's end. I pray for the long life of the precious Khensur Wandok, upholder of scriptural and realizational doctrines, spiritual friend who trained extensively in the five great philosophical texts, exceptional wisdom and perseverance. Tuji Rumchi Gutsi Shapi Denronang.
Tuji.
Sulamrim Chenmo Kamachirunang.